of my childhood was, of course, school days, and then after school, I remember myself picking my boots and going for training. So I've been a little professional right from I was 7 years old, so, and I'm happy to still be part of it. No, right from when I was seven, I started in the academy, in the youth academy, and when I was younger, we trained three times a week, so that would give me time to study. And when I grew, maybe from the age of 12, it was already everyday thing. But yeah, education is first, of course, when you're a kid, because you're not sure if you will make it big in football. So yeah, my parents monitored my education as well. So yeah, after, when it was more obvious that I'm very dedicated, I now said for now, football only. Yes, sure. My dad took me to the stadium from I was, I think, about 4 years old. And when I saw a full stadium and a beautiful game was played, I told my dad that I want to be a footballer also. It's a Nigerian league, Bendel Insurance. That was my first professional. As a professional, the game that I remember most is my first game against Genk in Belgium. That was the most beautiful stadium for me, you know, in an official league game. And it was a bit scary though. I was young, this big stadium, you know, it was my first steps in Europe, so it was a different whole thing, lots of pressure. But you know, when gaining experience, when you find yourself in situations like this once, twice, and then more than that, then you build confidence and get used to it. Well, every club, when you come in as a new player, they welcome you with applause, you know. When you feel welcome, you know, you're happy, and when you're happy, you normally do well. Yeah. Yes. I like the type of football they play here. I like the stadiums here. It's a country where people are really passionate about football. And yeah, I looked forward to playing here and ended up being here. Yeah. I scored on my debut for Albion, so yeah. It's a game I'll never forget. It still feels like yesterday to me against Sunderland. There was a message sent out that I'm interested in move to England. Yeah, an agent spoke to West Brom and they were looking for a striker at the moment. So it wasn't difficult when the three parties wanted that move, so they made it happen. Sometimes I do play on the wings, so but mostly as a striker, but you know, always in the front line, let's say.
And if so, who were they?
Yes, at the age of 15, when I was becoming more serious with football, I liked Brazilian striker Ronaldo, the one that played for Barcelona, and then Kanu Manko, our Nigerian striker. When they won the Olympic Games, I was following Nigerian football a lot and then wanted to play for Nigeria myself. And of course, we have great players like Okocha and Kanu, so they were my role models at the time, and then I started playing for Nigeria. At the moment, I would say Samuel Eto'o to me is a big example of a professional, because he has been around for about 10 years and he's been very consistent. So yeah, last year he had a move to Russia. We don't watch much of him, but before that I think he's a big example for any African player. Maybe the World Cup game match against Argentina, 2010. There are many great moments when you win. You know, I won a couple of medals, you know, Olympic medals. But I would say World Cup appearance was a very memorable one, and you know, at the highest level of football. And yeah, let's say coming in as a sub against Argentina in the World Cup. Future plans. I still have 2 years of contract with West Bromwich Albion. We wanna, you know, be a team that's performing on the highest level in the country to stay up in the league and keep doing it. Last year was the first time we stayed up in the league. This year we're gonna do it again, and you know, we wanna be a team that everyone will say they're not a yo-yo club anymore. We want to be the, let's say, the Liverpools and the Arsenals, yeah. But you have to start somewhere.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think we're building and a good team, and we're getting what we want so far. So my next 2 years are still here, and hopefully we'll only get better and better. I think African players are physically very strong, so very pacey. That means they have speed and a lot of technique. So I think that's why they are here. It's one of the best leagues in the world, and you know, pace matters a lot, and you know, that makes a difference. I think that's why they're here. Every player who is playing for Premiership now started back home. And the facilities, they are not the best, but you know, our presence here gives hope to the younger ones there who start to play, that they can get there, and you know, they know mostly the stories of everyone who got here, that they were not easy. So I think it gives them a lot of hope, and then they believe that working hard will pay one day, and they'll get to where they want to be.